ॐ नमो नारायणाय सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ श्री गणेशाय नमः। ॐ श्री सरस्वत्यै नमः। ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। ॐ समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं। ॐ सच्चिदानन्दरूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादिहेतवे तापत्रयविनाशाय श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः। ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भं शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। हरिः ॐ। सुस्वागतम्। वी ऑल आर स्टडिंग चैप्टर नंबर 4 ऑफ भगवद गीता, ज्ञान कर्म संन्यास योग, वेयर अर्जुना इज इन अ वेरी डिफरेंट सॉर्ट ऑफ माइंडसेट एंड ही हैज आस्क्ड द क्वेश्चन टू श्री भगवान दैट हाउ इज इट दैट यू सेड टू मी यू गिव दिस नॉलेज टू विवस्वान, बट विवस्वान्स बर्थ दैट मीन्स हिज एग्जिस्टेंस इज फ्रॉम इयर्स एंड इयर्स एंड इयर्स एंड इयर्स ऑलवेज देयर, बट भवतः जन्म ओहो कृष्ण यू आर ओनली एल्डर देन मी अराउंड 5-7 years, सो हाउ इज इट सो। श्री भगवानुवाच बहूनि मे व्यतीतानि जन्मानि तव चार्जुन तान्यहं वेद सर्वाणि न त्वं वेत्थ परन्तप। So yesterday we have seen this meaning of parantapa. We have given a good thought over that how one should able to find out our unique quality and serve this whole universe with that quality. Bhagavan says here, Arjuna, he parantapa, bahuni me vyatitani janmani, I have taken n number of birth, countless birth, tani aham veda sarvani, I know all of them. Why? Because I am not conditioned by upadhi. Tava, but you have also taken lot of birth, countless birth, but Tvam navetha, you do not know them at all. Why is it so? Because you are conditioned by mind, intellect and this body. That means upadhi is conditioning you, whereas I am absolutely unconditional, even though the upadhi is there with me. So, this is a beautiful verse which Bhagavan tells to every one of us. A deeper meaning, if we again dive deep into it, we can understand, if we ask this question, why birth? Why birth? So, Bhagavan in 13th chapter says, it is a reason of guna sanga. When this purusha, that is the kshetrajna, when it is attached to that gunas, what are the gunas? Sattva, rajas and tamas. One who has attachment to this gunas, that means a complete identification with the not self. That is the important aspect of it. Identification with the not self. Then what happens? Then there is a forgetfulness of our true nature. There's a forgetfulness of our true nature. Who am I? I do not really understand. I have no clue of it. And I have taken myself to be then this BMI, body, mind and intellect. And therefore, even though we also have gone through n number of countless births, but we do not know any of them except this present one. Bhagavan, this is something very different. But Bhagavan, I want to know, how is it possible that you are not conditional? You are not conditioned by this so-called as upadhi. And what is your upadhi? Bhagavan now says most beautiful verse, which Bhagavan is directly telling his own nature by his own presence and by his own direct indication. Ajopi san avyayatma bhutanam ishvaropi san prakrutim swamadhishthaya sambhavamyatma mayaya ajopi san avyayatma bhutanam ishvaropi san prakrutim swamadhishthaya sambhavamyatma mayaya. Bhagavan is explaining here and giving a direct indication about Bhagavan's two different nature. The real nature, the true nature, absolute nature, Bhagavan says, ajah, ajopi san. Even though I am unborn, son being, that means unborn is my nature. Being, this son is, it is my nature. From which standpoint? From absolute standpoint. So this standpoint, a seeker must understand and keep it in mind. Standpoint means when you look at the world, from which standpoint you are looking and from which standpoint you are relating to it, that we must able to know. So Bhagavan is telling here, ajopi san, even though I am unborn and it is my nature. It is my nature. What is nature? That without which the existence of it is not possible. That is called as nature. That without which the existence of is not possible. And this nature, one must keep an example in mind that Surya Devata, what is the nature? Light and heat. Light and heat is the nature of Surya Bhagavan. Now just imagine, without the light, without the heat, can there be any existence of Surya Bhagavan. So one must understand, yes, without the light, without the heat, there cannot be an existence of Surya Bhagavan. Similarly, the nature of Bhagavan from absolute standpoint is ajaha, unborn. Najayate mriyate va kadachit nayam bhutva bhavita vanabhuyah. That's what the nature, which is beautifully explained in 8th chapter. Yes or no? Half the people says, whether you say yet 8th chapter or 4th chapter, what makes the difference? We anyway do not remember at all. But anyway, let me tell you, it is in 2nd chapter. Bhagavan tells this beautiful indication, or it tells the knowledge of one's own true nature to Arjuna. So having said this first aspect of his true nature, now he says, avyaya atma san. Now san is this very important, this is being. Avyaya, imperishable atma tattva I am. So how is this imperishable atma tattva, which is explained beautifully this with this word called as avyaya? It is free from birth and death. And that is the meaning of this avyaya. Here specifically, because Bhagavan is telling his absolute nature. So Bhagavan is imperishable. And how is it? It is avyaya atma tattva san. But Bhagavan says, Arjuna, don't ever only imagine me as this alone, because I have another different nature from the standpoint of this world, which is called as Bhutanam Ishvaropi San. Now this San, again one has to understand, it is the nature of Bhagavan. Bhutanam Ishvara, the controller of every being in this universe. Controller of every being in this universe. So, please note, Bhagavan doesn't have to take birth. Why? Because it manifests whenever the Bhagavan wants, and it can finish that manifestation, or it can end that manifestation on its own. So this point one must put it in our so-called as intellect and lock it, that Bhagavan's manifestation can be at any level, any place, for n number of different reasons. Okay, Bhagavan, how do you manifest? What is that secret? Bhagavan says, tathapi sambhavami. That means, even though I am from my absolute standpoint is unborn, but I manifest. Sambhavami means to manifest. So, I manifest. How is it so? Prakrutim svam adhishthaya. Prakrutim svam adhishthaya. Presiding over my own prakruti. What is this prakruti, O Bhagavan? Sambhavamyatma mayaya. This prakruti is maya. And how is it this? Atma maya. It is my own maya power, divine power. So, beings is equal to bhavami, and भगवान इज इक्वल टू संभवामी. सो भवामी मीन्स बॉर्न एंड संभवामी मीन्स मैनिफेस्टेशन, कॉल्ड एज मैनिफेस्ट. सो लेट वी ऑल हैव दिस क्लैरिटी दैट दो वी सेलिब्रेट द कृष्ण जन्म अष्टमी, राम नवमी, द बर्थ ऑफ आवर डियर लॉर्ड, बट दैट डज नॉट मीन दैट वी हैव दिस रॉन्ग नोशन दैट देयर इज अ बर्थ ऑफ द लॉर्ड. देयर इज नो बर्थ, इट इज कॉल्ड एज मैनिफेस्टेशन. लेट अस बी वेरी क्लियर अबाउट इट. हाउ द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दे टेक बर्थ and they cannot manifest. Yes, this is also a very important aspect, because the birth of human beings is because of papa and punya, is because of papa and punya. That means the credentials of one's own, like every action when we do in life, not knowing the secret of action, with ignorance we do that action with selfish motive. Please understand this concept. When an ignorant person is doing an action with selfish motive, may it be a right action. What happens if he is doing his kartavya karma with this motto of some sort of selfishness? Then he will get, if he has done the best action, even though with this attitude, he will gain punya. But if he does not do his kartavya karma and still does the action with unrighteousness, then he will gain papa, which is called as demerit. So we all have done in our past lives n number of good and bad action with this attitude of selfishness, called as sakama vritti, and therefore is the conditioning of every being. And therefore, there is a continuous chain of birth for this Jiva Atma. Now, Bhagavan, please note this beautiful difference of a human being as a Jiva Atma and Bhagavan as a Ishvara. So, the first is, there is a birth of human being or any other creature in the world, but in case of Ishvara, it is not the birth, it is manifestation. So this is an important aspect. It is a manifestation. The birth of human being, called as Jiva Atma, it is because of papa and punya, whereas it is not because of papa and punya, it is because of his own choice. And now understand, we do not have a choice to take a birth or not to take a birth. Swamiji, it's too scary. Okay, let it be scary, but this is a fact. Then what should we do? Okay, wait. One must understand, one has to start doing the first level of karma yoga. So it will slowly purify the mind. And then, having purified the mind, one should able to devote or surrender at the feet of Guru and gain the right knowledge. And then this whole process called as the cycle of birth and death can end. Okay, now let us focus on Bhutanam Ishwaropi Sam. This is a very important aspect and we must understand it in toto. How is it so? First, every limited thing which we see in this world is coming from unlimited. Note this, everything which we see which is limited, okay, that which is limited is coming from unlimited. First concept. Okay, let me give simple example. The power which we have, which power? Power to see is coming from that Surya Devata, because that's the presiding deity of the eyes. Power to hear is coming from Dig Devata, because that's the presiding deity of the ears. Then power of speech. Oh my God, this is a very important aspect. Power of speech is coming from Agni Devata. Then power of touch is coming from Vayu Devata. Then power of taste is coming from Varuna Devata. Now just imagine, we have very limited power of it, and somewhere it is in abundance, it is unlimited source. Now you will appreciate, whatever we have as a wealth, how much we have? So everyone has a different wealth in their bank accounts or whatever. Sthavaram jangamam, movable and unmovable properties. So you can imagine, this wealth which we have is limited. So you can imagine, who is Bhagwan? Who is Aishwarya Sampanna? Aishwarya means that which is unlimited everything. Unlimited. It is beyond imagination. So that Bhagwan we understand as Ishwara has unlimited wealth. How is it so? Because Sakshat Lakshmi Mataji is the consort of the Bhagwan. So how can there be any limitedness at all? Okay. So hope this first important concept about Ishwara is clear. What we all have, everything in limited, that which we have in limited, it is with Bhagavan in unlimited capacity. Now, the purity which we have, whatever it is in measure, can you imagine? This purity is also coming from the same Bhagavan. Bhagavan. So the more you connect to that Bhagavan, the more you become pure. Just imagine. The more you connect to that Bhagavan, Supreme Truth, the more loving you become. The more you connect to that Bhagavan, the more you compassionate become. Just imagine how, let us connect to that universal source of every goodness. Please note, this is Bhagavan Ishwara. Bhagavan Ishwara. So this Bhagavan has unlimited everything. And this Bhagavan is beyond every reach of senses. Bhagavan cannot be reached by the senses. So how is this Bhagavan? Bhagavan can be reached with the power of love. And this Bhagavan Anon told every one of us. In ninth verse and in 12th, sorry, in the ninth chapter and in the 12th chapter, what Bhagavan says, I take responsibility of all my devotees. Ananyas chintayanto mam ye jana paryupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yoga kshema vahami aham. Now here Bhagavan's declaration and a very direct one. What is that? I take responsibility of all my devotees, those who unconditionally love me, those who take refuge in me unconditionally. I take complete responsibility. Now just imagine how big power it can be, or it should be, to take the complete responsibility of how many devotees? Can you imagine? There are crores and crores of devotees. Our oxygen supply, during the crisis, we have all experienced how short it is. But Bhagavan's oxygen supply is 24/7 unlimited. Just imagine. When we do something, it is always limited. But when Bhagavan does, that is always unlimited. Unlimited. Okay. So, what we have seen, this important aspect about the wealth and the power. Now, the direction which is important. See, a very practical example. We all, whenever we travel to sort of places where we do not know the path to reach to a right address. And therefore, nowadays, everyone puts a GPS. GPS. And then it navigates you from its right direction. Just imagine. Now, let me just explain this important aspect. What is that? This GPS is also possible because of human intellect. A team of brilliant people, they have beautifully discovered, as well as they have, you know, sort of organized, or they have given this beautiful aspect of science to the world as a gift. It's a boon. Now just imagine, if we require for our navigation to reach to right address that intelligent indicator which is called as GPS, can you not imagine to reach to that supreme truth, the same navigator, which is the supreme intelligence, is required for every one of us to reach to that supreme truth. Please understand and reflect over. So to get the right direction, it is the grace of that divine power which is called as Bhagavan. Please understand this. Whosoever is walking on this path with whatever capacity is also because of that grace of Bhagavan. Because to whatever extent you have asked for it, and you have connected yourself with that source, and therefore we got this path. Now, another aspect of it, which is very delicate and beautiful. See, if you reach to your address, if you reach to your final supreme goal, now, is that the death of the body? No. So, what is called as realization? Jivan Mukta. being in this body, this person is completely free of all bondages. Now, who all helped this person? N number of people. What are the most prominent people? Guru and Mata Pita. Please note it. Guru and Mata Pita, a very important aspect of this journey reaching towards the supreme goal. Now just imagine, having gained the knowledge, can you say, now I am Brahma, so for me there is no guru. I don't recognize any guru. Please think, can it be? No, not possible. So if somebody goes on this level and expresses like this ignorant sort of thing, like I don't require a guru, or I have done my final, I have reached to my final goal, and therefore I don't recognize any guru, I don't recognize any Mata Pita, I am only Mahatma Tattva. So this is not right thing as per as this transactional world is concerned. So therefore, when we are in transactional world, we must have every moment this gratitude. Every moment this gratitude that whatever I have achieved is because of that universal divine power. Whatever you have achieved is because of that universal divine power. And one must have a gratitude. Similarly, we must have a gratitude towards our Guru, who is also a representative of the same Bhagavan, who is guiding us towards the supreme goal. Similarly, our mother and father are also representatives of the same Bhagavan, who has given us such a great life, such a beautiful life in this human existence. So, can you please think, will your gratitude towards your Guru will grow or will reduce, having gained the knowledge? It will increase enormously. Having gained the knowledge, your love towards your Guru will increase or decrease? Will increase immeasurably. Similarly, towards your mother and father, your love, your compassion will increase or decrease? Will increase enormously. Now just imagine, can you have a right contact with them or not? Yes, I have a great right contact and I treasure it. What? My Guru is the most beautiful treasure, the most precious treasure, wealth in my life. Think, yes or no? My mother and father, whosoever, is the greatest treasure, is the greatest gift in my life. Think. Whose gift it is? It is a gift of that same Paramatma Tattva. Karturagyaya Prapyate Phalam. Please never forget this verse. Whatever I am getting in this world is because the prasad of the same universal divine power, which is called as Bhagavan, which is called as Ishwara. Then having gained the knowledge, how anyone can be ungrateful towards that Bhagavan? And how somebody can think that, oh, puja? Puja is an inferior quality of sadhana, or inferior quality of action towards this supreme goal. So I don't require any puja of any Bhagavan. Oh, then we have nothing to say about it at all. Because if such a person who says, I don't require, or I don't actually get into it, or whatever, it is because of his or her so-called as ungratefulness. That does not mean that for a realized person, there is anything which is called as compulsion. There is no compulsion. But his love towards that Bhagavan is so much that he or she just cannot resist but to express that love towards that divine in different forms. In different forms. So I'll give you a very important aspect to it. How this worship one must understand. This example will just fit in here completely. Lokmanya Tilak Maharaj. You know, once it happened so, he was from Ratnagiri, but he used to stay in Mumbai because of his whole freedom work for India. He was a great freedom fighter. So his house was not that big, a small house that time. So his brother and his so-called brother's both sons, that means his nephews, they came to his place. Now Tilak Maharaj, he was from the Brahmin family, and at that time there was a very strict rule that every Brahmin person should do, which is called as Sandhya Vandanam. So both these boys, nephews, are there in the house, and they see Lokmanya Tilak Maharaj not doing any Sandhya, not doing any Puja. They told to their father, oh dear father, why don't we also follow the same? Why? Because your brother, who is so great, doesn't do it at all. So don't ask us to do it. Today onwards, we are going to stop it. Now he was in a fix. You know, Lokmanya Tilakji's brother was in fix because there was no answer for it in his mind. So he went to Lokmanya Tilak, oh my dear brother, see my both boys are telling this and I have no answer. Can you please explain them and please correct them? Lokmanya Tilakji said, yes, no doubt. He called both the nephews and told, please come with me on the terrace of the house. They went on the terrace of the house and he showed them, see, can you see this a line which is there? People are standing in queue in front of my room. They said, yes. See, they are there because they have n number of difficulties. And I have given up my whole life to the service of this Janardana, one who is inside everyone, and that I consider as my worship. So if you also have this thought, you also can rise to this level, you should not do any sort of puja to any Bhagavan as a ritual. Both of them understood, my God, this we can't do at all. They started doing their Sandhya Vandanam very regularly. Now please understand, worship is not in one form. Worship is in different forms, as per our own quality of the mind and intellect, as per our own status of this upadhi. But worship is must. Why? Because still you are taking so much from this prakriti of Bhagavan. Think, yes or no. 24/7 we have unlimited supply of oxygen. 24/7 we have supply of pure light which is called as the light of Surya Bhagwan, and so on and so forth. So, how can I be ungrateful towards that Supreme Lord who is compassionately, every moment is taking care of everything in this small, limited upadhi, as well as he's taking care of the unlimited, universal, big upadhi, which is called as Prakriti. See, this Prakriti is also under the control of Bhagavan. One more example, if you can appreciate. All the planets, what is the size of the planets? It is beyond imagination. A planet as an earth, how big it is? Oh my God, just oh my God is a word. Where it is resting? Where it is resting? It is in space. It is in the space. Can you imagine? This huge mass, which is called as a planet Earth, and other planets are all in space, and nothing is seen as gross substratum to it at all. But all the planets are in complete right motion, with right speed, with right everything, and there is not a trace of confusion or any sort of mismanagement or disorganization at all. Can you just imagine how compassionately that Lord works for the whole universe to remain in harmony? Therefore, we must understand everything which is happening in this universe is not an accident, and it cannot be an accident possible. Why? Because it is programmed by the Supreme Intelligence, which is called as Ishvara, the Bhagavan, the universal controller. And therefore, if we have some knowledge, if we have some gratitude, then we must understand there is only one way. Sarva dharman parityajya. Let us completely surrender this limited beingness to that complete, universal, unlimited being. And that is actually the gift to that Lord, to that universal divine power, to understand that presence of that divine power is always required for this limited being to function at any level. Think about it. How much gratitude and how much love one can develop one who gets this knowledge. Now think, is this love a sort of conditional love? And can it be any conditional love towards such a divine power? Not possible. One who gains this knowledge grows and rises above all sort of limitedness, all sort of demands, all sort of expectations, all sort of any which is called as incompleteness in this world, and remains ever grateful to that ever compassionate divine power which is called as Ishwar. One must reflect continuously on this verse that how Bhagavan is compassionate. Now last but not the least, that compassionate Lord, the universal power, that Brahman, for the sake of love, he can become a charioteer. Can you imagine? He can wash and clean the horses. He can feed the horses. He can clean the stable. For what? Just imagine. Bhakto sime sakha cheti rahasyam hetaduttamam. Anyway, this is a secret, my dear friends, and this secret can only come to one and one alone who has this quality, which is called as Bhaktosime Sakhajeti. There should be a very strong relation with that supreme universal power. You may have any relation like that of gopis of Vrindavan, like that of Arjuna, like that of Yashoda Maiya, like that of Shri Parvati ji, like that of Vidura Bhagavata, Vidura ji, like that of Uddhava, like that of Narad ji, like that of Bhakta Prahlad, whatever is possible, like that of Hanuman ji. So, it is not just a study, but it is a great revelation that how we can connect to that supreme divine power, which is our original source of everything. Let us contemplate and be with that universal power. With his compassion, every one of us has gained whatever in this life. And this is also true. With his grace and compassion and love, alone we can reach to that supreme goal of human existence. Therefore, it is extremely important to connect to that controller, the Ishvara, the supreme divine power. What is the method? Surrender. Surrender. Yat Shreyasya Nishchitam Bruhi Tanme Shishyasteham Shadhimam Tvam Prapannam. O Lord, please accept me as your disciple. I surrender to your lotus feet, not for any material demand, but for one and one alone, to reach to you yourself, to be one with you. O Lord, please shower your grace and blessings. पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांतिः। हरि ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरि ओम
नमो नारायण।